Hey everyone, Boris from FreedomFi here. 7 years ago, I presented at OpenStack Summit how to deploy an OpenStack cluster with Puppet manifests for Go.
How to stand up an HA OpenStack cloud with Open Puppet manifests in under 20 minutes for Go.
So today we're going to take it to the next level. I'm going to show you how to build your own private LTE network using open source software and commodity hardware. Also for gold. Let's get started. So why build an LTE network? There are basically three reasons. First is because your signal can go very, very far. Second is because your wireless connection will be very reliable. And third is because LTE network is easily upgradable to 5G. And we all know that today 5G is very, very cool. Building LTE networks is no task for nerds like deploying Kubernetes. It requires some equipment and it requires resourcefulness. The first thing that you will need to build an LTE network is some spectrum. There are two types of spectrum in this world. There is licensed spectrum and unlicensed spectrum. Unlicensed spectrum is your 2.4 GHz, 5 GHz, and a few other frequency bands that are commonly used for Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and other things. Licensed spectrum is pretty much all other frequency bands. And all LTE radios are designed to use licensed spectrum. To be able to use licensed spectrum, you need special permission from the government. You can check out the Wikipedia page to get a list of different licensed spectrum bands. If you wanted to get some spectrum from the government 10 years ago, it would look something like this.
Here I am, next to the FCC building. Judging by the quality of construction, this is a very high budget organization. I'm gonna go and get some spectrum now.
Hello, I would like to buy some spectrum.
Hello, my friend. You come to the right place. What is your budget?
Looks like my budget is $231.37 and also 500 rubles.
The cost of the spectrum is $100 billion.
Luckily today, the spectrum is becoming much more accessible. In the USA, there is a number of companies that have been authorized by the government to make 5G ready spectrum available for private use in an on-demand fashion through a program called Citizens Broadband Radio Service, also known as CBRS. The two most popular companies that provide such a service is Federated Wireless and Google. All you need is an API call and a credit card, and you get your 5G ready clean spectrum. At FreedomFi, we know some good people at Federated Wireless and Google. So if you become customer, we will hook you up with some spectrum for free. Another thing that you need to build an LTE network is a radio. If you were to go and try get a radio 10 years ago, it would look something like this. Let's get some radios. Hello, I would like to buy some radios for my private LTE network.
You've come to the right place, my friend. What is your budget?
$100 billion?
That is the right answer.
So we normally sell our radios to large telecom operators and we have great selection. We have baseband units for different use cases and remote radio heads distributed models. You have to interconnect those using our proprietary interfaces and specialized cables, of course. To make them work, you will also need to buy specialized network management software from us. We have a great licensing model. Other licensing models, total disasters.
So, unlike the macro cells, the sales process for which you have just witnessed, today there is an emerging market of compact LTE radios called small cells. Small cells, like this guy right here, you can actually go and buy on the internet for not that much money. Small cells that are designed to work with CBRS frequency bands are called CBSDs, Citizen Broadband Radio Devices. Unlike Wi-Fi access point, CBSDs, or most small cells, do not come with an antenna. So you have to go and buy an antenna separately. Antennas come in all shapes and sizes. Right here, we have regular Omni antennas. But the antennas that you see on Verizon towers and AT&T towers that look like this big, big rectangle standing upright are called sector antenna. So for this demonstration here, we'll be using the Omnis, but when we teach the GOAT, we'll be using sector antenna. Now that we have our radio, our antenna, and our spectrum, the next thing to get is a piece of software called the network core. The network core is an operating system of an LTE or 5G network. All of your radios will connect into it, all of your SIM card data is going to be inputted into it, various traffic shaping and quality of service rules for your network are going to be configured in the network core. If you wanted to get a network core 10 years ago, but we've learned our lesson and we're not going back to this guy. Today, there are many open source packet core that you can download on the internet. The best open source packet core that we like at FreedomFi is called Magma. Magma is available to download for free at magmacore.org. Magma network core consists of two components. First component is called Access Gateway, and this is your data plane component. Second component is called the Orchestrator, and this is your control plane component. To build a private LTE network using Magma, you will take Access Gateway and you will install it on a cheap X86 appliance you can get from Amazon that looks like this. Then you will take your orchestrator and you will install it on any cloud service like AWS. After this part is done, you are ready to start putting it all together and building your network. First, you take your antennas and you connect them to your base station. Once this piece is done, you take this guy right here and you put it somewhere on the roof high up where it can transmit very good. I'm not going to demonstrate this part right here, but the GOAT will do it. Second, you take your appliance with the access gateway installed on it and you connect it to the port on your small cell. Let me demonstrate. The last step in your assembly process is to connect this whole thing to the internet. To do this, you take your appliance of access gateway on it, and you connect a cable, a regular Cat6 cable into it. You connect the other side of that Cat6 cable into any switch that has internet access. After that, the orchestrator will automatically discover your gateway and your cell, and you can start configuring your network. The last piece that you will need to make your network operational is a SIM card. A SIM card, as you probably know, goes into any LTE device like a phone to make it connect to your network. The hard thing about a SIM card is not getting SIM card. There are many SIM cards on the internet. The hard thing is programming the correct parameters into the SIM card so it connects to your network. Your best bet to not screw this part up is to ask the vendor that you're buying your SIM cards from to do the programming for you. At FreedomFi, we work with an excellent vendor called SmartJack, and we know some good people there. So if you need help, we make introduction for you to get SIM cards. Now that we have all the components together and we know how to build network, it is time to teach the GOAT how to build the LTE network. First, let me introduce you to the crew. Our first crew member, of course, is the GOAT. Our second crew member is Joey. He's an experienced LTE guy and also experienced in the art of taming the GOAT. For this tutorial, we may need to go through the steps a little fast. But do not worry. Joey is going to be documenting his experience of teaching the GOAT and he's posting the blog on the website of FreedomFi for you to read and follow step by step. Let's get started.